The question is, so this is a family farm,
yes,
belonging to your family probably for many, many years, and you are managing the pool. How many hectares all in all you have in the family?
There are 29 hectares.
29 yes. hectares. And how many caretakers?
Caretakers, there are six of them.
Yes. And then you are the head caretaker for the whole
yes, you can
family
consider
business.
It.
Yes. And so most of the ponds, this is a large pond for this area.
Yes. Yes.
So how many ponds do you have on the 29 hectares, more or less? Many?
I will count.
Oh,
more or less.
Seven, tanyido.
Oh, seven plus ito. Around 20 also.
20 fish pounds.
Yes. We are relying on the natural food and the small shell. For crabs as well. Tubing. I don't know how they call this one.
Lasangas.
And this is the lumula in your country, is mula. Here we call it tahong.
Yes.
Tahong. This is the free food here. In India, the innovative awardee, Dr. Pillai, is the one invented this asula to convert into feeds. No, he's a billionaire. Yeah. He converted this asula into feeds to supply the food of the cows, pigs in India. It multiply rapidly.
Yes.
And this is the lumut, other source food of bangus. Yeah, this is the lumut. They call it algae. Yes. Lamuyak.
But you
in Bangasinan, this is lamuyak. And at night, I'm feeding also the sinker feeds.
And you have enough supply of this small shell from the river?
From the river, yes. Because they don't know that shell is can use to feed the banami.
Ah, so we're the only one to know.
Yes. Just like now, maybe they can get 16 sacks. Yesterday they get 15 sacks every day. So there's so many natural food you can feed to the banami here.
And do you apply the same techniques on the 29 hectares?
Or yes, my own technique. Based on my research, yes.
Your own technique.
I'm not following the traditional method, but I'm using the modern, as I consider a modern method.
So, to be more precise, what is, to summarize in 2, 3, 10, or 15 words, what is the traditional method?
Traditional method is the they just plant the algae, they just plant the algae, then they have to wait till the algae finish, then they will harvest. Yeah, but so sometimes it takes 6 months to harvest. That's the traditional method. But now I'm using them just like modern method. But I'm feeding different feeds of the fish, food of the fish, just like this small shells. The just like this other, you can consider this source of protein.
Yes,
and the maggots, using maggots. Yes.
And actually, so the revolution for your farm is the maggot, a little bit. When did you start the maggot production?
Maybe 6 months already. I took the head of the fish, the intestine.
Yes.
Then I make maggots.
Yes.
Every morning I harvest like that drum of maggots, because I observed that in Japan and in Africa. They are using that as a source of protein.
Very interesting, because my friends here, they are working with a team of scientists who work on the maggot production for aquaculture.
Yes.
And in the Philippines, you're the first one I met, first fisherman I know, the first farmers I met.
Yes.
Who is using maggot also. Sometimes you're using probiotics.
Yes,
also.
But natural organic probiotics.
Produced by him.
Yeah.
And so how do you, if you're producing probiotic, how do you produce it? What?
All the plants that I'm using the plants,
yes.
the
new buds.
The tip of the plants. Buds, right? New buds. I'm cutting that at night so that all the nutrients and vitamins. Then I fermented for 7 days.
I see.
Yeah, and I'll take the liquid form. Yes. Then I mix with lactobacillus.
Ah yes.
Yes. That's my probiotics. And it serves as a growth promoter and it cured the deduction of the survival of the baname.
Yes. And you're really confident that there is a significant impact of the use of your secret probiotic?
Yes, because as I researched, they are using that in Japan.
Yes.
It is effective also in chicken. How much more in baname?
Ah, yes.
Yeah. As I observed, the baname is every day getting lesser because of the. When I use the probiotics, the next day no more dead baname.
I would like to add that here or in Pampanga you always have a small percentage of farmers like this gentleman who are always innovative. They will learn something and they will try.
Yes.
So they will try. And if it doesn't work, they will stop and step back to something else. But always innovative. Trying new technique, new system.
What does that mean for the other one? They are using traditional system and they doesn't try anything else?
Yes, they are using the traditional system. But for me, before my parents, they are harvesting the pan. It takes six months to harvest. But now we can harvest 2 months in 16 days.
Baname.
Yes.
Before we are harvesting 4 months, but when I started using those probiotics, those shells, the maggots, you cannot believe I harvest for 2 months and 16 days. Usually 3 to 4 months.
Did you study aquaculture before?
Or? Actually, I study in fisheries, but through research. So I learned from the other country, their techniques.
And you study in fisheries here in Binmali?
Yes.
Yes.
High school.
High school.
Yes. But I took up management in Manila. Business management. Then I work also in different countries.
In this area, you have farmers which are totally innovative.
Yeah.
You abandon the siganid because it's a difficult fish, it's not growing fast, the survival is not good. But you have that other farmer here working with maybe barangay also.
We have one barangay here who are actually producing siganid.
Yes.
They're at barangay Malindung.
Yes. And they make also, they were also innovative, inventing new things. And you know, also that sort of typical farmer who will go his own way, own innovative way to improve his profit, to improve the quality of his farm. Thank you very much.
Parcel harvest la ba yun? Ngayon po dyan, nandami na amay hindi pa na yung na-stress so amay bangus kami.
Marmulat portion.
Tay tubo,
Thank you.
Pen naman nung sa height to.
Wala naman ang tika, ha?
Ah. Ito lang.
What's this one?
Speedfish.
Speedfish? Good to eat?
Yeah. It grows, it bigs like plates.
Malaga.
Okay. Oh, this is the tilapia. Tilapia.
Red tilapia.
Tilapia. Orange.
Florida.
Florida. Tilapia. This is the crab in the Philippines, small crab. This is the banami. Live banami. See, alive tempura. And this is the tilapia. This is the tilapia. Masuk ay. Thank you. yeah. It looks like bangus, but it is not a bangus. It is not a bangus. It is just like an arwana.
Yes.
The arwana?
Yes.
It's, yeah.
Oh, I think it is. Isn't it megalops? Megalops. It's eating fish. Or?
Yes, eating baname. This one.
Yes. So it's megalops. Maybe megalops cypsinoides.
See, the mouth. It's bigger.
Yeah, yeah. Megalops cypsinoides.
Oh.
Small tarpon.
This is the we call it. Tawag nito.
Mallet.
Mallet. Mallet. Yes. Small mallet.
Alors ça, cette exploitation des temps illustre très bien ce système de pisciculture extensif en intrants qui est très très différent de ce que nous avons vu hier en cage à Anda. Et pour illustrer ça, un rapide calcul permet de dire que dans cet étang de 2 hectares et demi environ, il y a un cinquième de ce qu'il y avait dans cette cage de 18 mètres de 18 mètres de diamètre que nous avons exploité hier. Il y avait 5 fois plus de poissons que dans cet étang. Alors, dans l'étang qu'on exploite maintenant, on utilise très peu d'aliments. Et donc, cet étang est en fait extensif en intrants, mais intensif en foncier et intensif en travail. Il y a par kilo de poisson produit beaucoup plus de travail qui est. Il y a le coût du travail par kilo de poisson produit ici est beaucoup plus important que dans l'exemple que nous avons vu hier, c'est cette cage à Anda. Mais en revanche, ici, on utilise beaucoup moins d'aliments, on est beaucoup plus extensif en ressources alimentaires. Le poisson est produit avec de l'aliment naturel, des algues, un petit peu d'aliments artificiels, mais pas beaucoup. Et donc, c'est un système qui est à l'opposé et complémentaire aussi du système qu'on a vu hier.
Pourquoi un petit peu d'aliments industriels? Pourquoi est-ce qu'on met ça?
Mais pour pouvoir garder un niveau de densité qui permette de rentabiliser les surfaces, en fin de croissance, ou après 2 mois sans nourrissage du tout, on va complémenter la ressource naturelle de l'étang ou la ressource de l'alimentation sous forme d'algues. On va complémenter ça avec un petit peu d'aliments naturels.
C'est pour booster un peu?
Mais ça permet de garder dans les temps et d'assurer la croissance dans les temps et de garder dans les temps des densités de poissons qui font que l'ensemble du système sera tout de même plus rentable. Mais les indices de consommation seront beaucoup plus intéressants au final que sur une cage telle qu'on a vu hier où on va donner entre 2,6 et 2,8 kg d'aliments pour produire 1 kg de poisson. Et si, par rapport à la quantité d'aliments artificiels achetés dans le commerce. La quantité d'aliments artificiels achetés dans le commerce sera sans doute de l'ordre de 0,5 kg d'aliments artificiels pour produire 1 kg de poisson.
Ce qui était intéressant, c'est ce que tu nous disais hier sur la nécessité d'allouer son capital entre travail, nourriture, foncier et tout ça.
Mais que ce soit en pisciculture ou ailleurs, c'est l'entrepreneur ou l'opérateur va toujours valoriser et du travail et du foncier et du capital, même s'il produit, des réfrigérateurs, disons. Il va avoir différentes catégories de facteurs de production. Alors, le capital, en l'occurrence, dans l'exemple qu'on a vu hier dans cette cage, c'est essentiellement l'aliment. Enfin, c'est aussi la construction de la cage, les bateaux qui fonctionnent avec des moteurs, etc., etc., etc. Donc, ici, on va parler de foncier, c'est aussi du capital d'une certaine façon. Mais enfin, on rentabilise le foncier. Donc, sur 2,5 hectares, on va mettre 12 000 chanos et 350 000 crevettes vanamei. Mais on valorise le foncier, évidemment, beaucoup plus que... Le foncier est un facteur de production qui est essentiel sur ce type de système. C'est intensif en foncier.
Ce que tu nous disais aussi sur la personne qui s'occupe de la culture, à savoir qu'il était très novateur.
Ah, c'est vrai, il est très novateur, puisque le système traditionnel va être d'associer la production de chanos dans ces étangs à de relativement faible densité avec l'apport des algues loumottes, ces algues filamenteuses dont se nourrissent les chanos. Mais ils complémentent l'alimentation des crevettes avec des coquillages qu'ils écrasent et qu'ils récoltent localement, et avec une production d'asticots. Il a une petite unité de production d'asticots qui lui permet d'intensifier sa production et de sécuriser l'alimentation des crevettes qui lui rapporte évidemment beaucoup d'argent.
Okay, and this small tilapia. You can try this and feed to the banami. The banami will feed also on this tilapia, source of protein also.